This fantastic clock radio here is the Philco model T1000 from 1959. Some people call it the Predicta clock radio, but it was not marketed as such as far as I know. However, it would fit well in a room with a Predicta TV, as the styling is similar. This is one of the most, if not the most, stylish transistor clock radios, but there are other contenders for that title. This particular example is now in fully working condition. The clock was not functional when I got it, and that's pretty common. It's not easy to disassemble because it was not meant to come apart and be serviced, but I was able to take it apart and fix it. I'll show some pictures of the inside of that mechanism. Currently the radio is set to off. Let's switch it on. It's pretty sensitive to interference, unfortunately. Partly as a result of the long wires running everywhere. Particularly the power wires running up to the clock mechanism. This radio is pretty sensitive to interference, so I had to move it away from all possible sources of interference, at least as best as I could, which means filming in a somewhat awkward location on top of my bed. So without further ado, let's hear it play. The volume control is right here.
Seeking God's will. Look in verse 15. This messenger takes the mystery out of your finances.
Love it.
Liberty 960.
To do the wild thing, she loved to do the wild thing.
It is a guarantee that you will miss on some draft picks. First round picks, fifth round picks, doesn't matter. It's going
to... Even a single PSI lower than recommended means worse mileage and more trips to the pump. So do the environment and your wallet a favor. Radio Earth and the National Environmental Education Foundation. To find more tips on smarter or to take action in your own community, go to iHeartRadio.com/earth.
As you heard, it plays quite well, both when it's playing quietly and when it's playing loud. Those dual speakers really give this radio a nice sound. You can also set it to auto, which will make the radio come on when the hour hand comes around to where the little red alarm indicator is. You can move that around with this. That moves counterclockwise, by the way. Don't try to force it the other way around. Or you can use the sleep timer function over here. You can see the only markings on the sleep dial are 0 and 60. So if you want to fall asleep to a precise amount of radio, this is not the radio for that. On the front here is a little plaque that you could remove and have engraved with your name or something else. I'm sure some of these were used as gifts. And hidden behind this plate, which is a little bit hard to pry off, are the antenna and oscillator tuning screws for the radio. You can use that to fine-tune the alignment once the radio is installed in the case. I put a wad of paper towel behind the case here so it's not pressing down on the time setting knob, which protrudes from the back of the case. Something you have to be careful with. Now, if any of you are looking to buy one of these, this is what you want to see in the underside view. Most of these have a rotted out bottom cover from battery leakage. This one is in immaculate condition. It looks like batteries never leaked in here. The springs are perfect. That is very hard to find. Took me a while to get this one. The sticker is upside down. But the serial number is 99176. Let's see, T1000-124. I forget what the 124 thing is. Philco added that to a lot of their model numbers. It's powered by 3 D cells, 2 for the radio and 1 for the clock. To take the back cover off, you just remove these 4 screws. You'll notice that even the rubber feet on this thing are perfect. They're pretty tiny relative to the size of the, you know, clock radio, so I'm kind of surprised they didn't get squished over the years. And there's 2 slotted holes here for hanging this thing on your wall. And you can actually tilt the entire face of this thing, like so, to face forward if it's hanging on your wall. Not sure how many people did that, but I guess that would be kind of interesting. With those 4 screws out, we can now get inside the battery and chassis compartment. See, the cover is pretty much immaculate. There's the 3 batteries for it. And there's the radio chassis. Now, despite the size of this set, Philco being Philco had to use one of their weird output transformerless designs with a center-tapped battery compartment. And that means they had to use a 2-contactor power switch inside the clock mechanism. Which connects the positive of one of the batteries and the negative of the other, both together and to the middle terminal, which goes to the And this does have 2 speakers, one in each one of these compartments here. They're fairly good-sized speakers. One issue I ran into, and you surely will as well, is that the foam padding that held them in place completely disintegrated into dust. So I had to replace that, and then paint the new foam that I installed there black. I use weather stripping foam, which will hopefully hold up a long time. We'll see. This transformer core you see here is the input transformer. Normally I'd show you guys the other side of the chassis, but it's actually quite a bit of a pain to remove. You can't just slip the chassis out. You have to very carefully either pull the circuit board out once you've gotten it, you know, free of the clips, and pull it free of the tuning dial, or undo the screws that hold this base plate here to this metal piece here, and then get under there and pull the tuning dial off by hand. It's not easy to work on really any part of this. There's the ferrite antenna bar. It's quite generously sized. So when this radio is away from interference sources and you're listening at nighttime, the reception is actually quite good. I'm happy with it. There's the serial number again. It matches the one on the bottom cover. To get at the compartments for the clock and speakers, you just need to take out the screw on the bottom of each respective compartment and then lift them up. To get at the clock, you of course have to pull these out first, but that's really the least of your problems. The clock mechanism itself is held onto the face of the dial with push-on clips, which are then glued in place. They were a real pain in the neck to remove, but I was able to get them off without destroying things in here. And I got the clock running well. It's actually running a little bit fast with the modern oil I put on there. I'm gonna have to try and regulate that down to the correct speed.